We were really looking forward to seeing the Merovingian in Matrix Resurrections. However, his appearance was extremely short. It was more like a cameo that didn't add much to the plot. Even though his appearance was brief, there is a deeper meaning behind his humorous ranting that reveals how he lost everything, maybe even opening the doors for future Matrix projects focused on the Exiles. Today we're going to talk about the ill fate of the Merovingian. Welcome to Matrix Explained.
Welcome to the desert of the real.
After the events of Matrix Revolutions, a new war between the machines shortly began. Some machines did not want to continue with the truce, thus they searched for a greater source of energy. This new source of energy is the Anomalium, from where Neo and Trinity's powers would be taken to increase energy production for the simulation. The analyst's focus was to lead the effectiveness of the Matrix's energy production. This is a clue to what sparked the machine's civil war in the first place: energy deficiency from releasing too many blue pills. The point is that when the analyst took control, he decided to create a new simulation, but not before purging all the Exiles. At least that's what the Red Pills believe. The Architect used the Exiles for his cycle. He used programs like the Oracle, the Keymaker, even the Merovingian to contribute their little grains of sand to perpetuate the Path of the One. However, this changed with Neo. With the breaking of the Path of the One, the truce was created, and with the arrival of the Analyst, a new version of the Matrix began. We are not sure which version of the Matrix this is, but it's probably the 7th version. A version based on feelings, and that uses fantasies to plunge people into this false reality. It is now easier to understand what the Merovingian is referring to. During Neo and Smith's conversation, Zeke tells Bugs that he is picking up some low-frequency portals. This means that the Merovingian and several Exiles are still alive, but their living conditions have changed. Before, Merv and his men were hiding inside the Matrix in a luxurious skyscraper and a mountain chateau. But now, they reside in low-frequency locations, hiding from the Analyst, like fugitives. Merv blames Neo for this. The Frenchman appears and says to Neo, "You. Oh, it is you. All these years. I can't believe it. You stole my life." The Merovingian insults Neo in French because it's Neo's fault that the Frenchman lost his life of luxury and power. The Merovingian knew how the Path of the One worked. He had outlived all of Neo's predecessors.
"Mark my words, boy, and mark them well. I have survived your predecessors, and I will survive you."
But the truce broke the cycle, and the Merovingian was no longer needed within the simulation. The purge was massive, and the Merovingian cannot regain his life of luxury. "You ruined everything," the Merovingian continues. "We had grace, we had style, we had conversation, not this." He mimics the sound of texting. "Art, films, books were all better. Originality mattered. You gave us Faye Sucker Book and me Clementi Wiki." Obviously, we can't translate our dear Frenchman's cursing, but he is on a rant because this new simulation is focused on distracting technologies like the internet and video games. It's a place where originality is being lost, just like in our world, and the movie is criticizing this reality. Remember that the Merovingian was an information smuggler.
"You know why we are here."
"I am a trafficker of information. I know everything I can."
Knowledge is no longer as important. All the people are connected to a simulation where art is corrupt and originality is dying. The Merovingian is referring to his life: sophisticated, cultured, and classy. But this life is lost in the new simulation because of Neo's actions. But there is a purpose to this rant, and it is criticism of modern society who no longer care about creativity or in-person conversations. They just want to be glued to their smart devices. The last thing the Merovingian says is, "This is not over yet. Our sequel franchise spin-off." So now we kind of understand the purpose of the Merovingian's brief appearance. More than just announcing a hypothetical sequel or spin-off, this is a commentary on the absurdity of modern movie plots, where an insignificant character makes a cameo just to plant the seed for a possible sequel or spin-off. This is connected to what the Frenchman was ranting about. Originality is dead, which is why he scoffs at the situation by screaming about a spin-off. If the reference is still not clear enough, this was a mockery of action and superhero movies where a minor character makes a momentary appearance to then reappear later in their own spin-off, creating a loop of nostalgia where creativity takes a back seat and where imagination dies. The Merovingians' diatribe, funny enough, connects to the Matrix Resurrections after-credit scene. The post-credit scene is of the Deus Machina's game designer group still brainstorming about what their next game should be. Quoting the movie, "Face reality, people. Movies are dead. Games are dead. Narrative? Dead. Media is nothing but neuro-trigger responses and viral conditioning. What we need is a series of videos that we call the Catrix." End quote. This is a clear mockery of films with after-credit scenes, a tired and foolish practice, but still popular, and one that is focused on triggering those neural responses that the scene itself mentions. It is dead art being replaced by a product that only activates superficial emotions and does not transcend. So was the Merovingian right? Is all originality lost, and the times are much worse than before? That we are used to consuming these processed and canned pieces of supposed art? Have we lost our dignity, and that people might have preferred to see this Catrix instead of Matrix 4? Pretty sure plenty of fellow YouTubers might. We don't believe there's going to be a sequel or spin-off with the Merovingian, sadly. It would have been interesting to know more about his story, though. But we believe that his purpose was to be a social critic, and nothing more. But do you agree? Would you like to see a Merovingian spin-off or sequel?
The place where you live is not the place you once dreamed of? Are you sick of your hot and filthy Zion apartment? Then we have the solution for you. Bad credit or criminal history? We can wipe your slate clean and give you a fresh start. We at Megacity Realty can find you the most luxurious real estate, where you can spend hours playing your favorite virtual reality video game, eating the most delicious meals, and having an endless supply of blue medications. What are the blue pills for? No need to worry, because you will be bathing in the most phenomenal bathtub, with the best view of the city. And only minutes away from the best cafeteria in the city. Why wait? Contact one of our agents and be reconnected to the home of your dreams. Megacity Realty. Offer valid while the truce lasts.
For Matrix Explained, please leave a like and subscribe. And thank you for visiting the Desert of the Real.